Hello, welcome to my channel. My name is Tessa Rae, and today I'm going to be sharing with you some hip stuff, some hip work that we can do to increase your groin flexibility in order to either just increase your range of motion to prevent injuries as an athlete or just as a normal human being using your body, and potentially also to help us heal injuries or work through some scar tissue, because this area is actually one of the most commonly injured areas of our body. Before we get started, I would like to encourage you to subscribe to my channel to encourage me to continue to create content for you. Also, I would love to hear about your experience in the comment section. If you have any requests for future videos, I would also love to hear from you. That's takes the thinking out of it for me, and I really love to just make you happy. So let me know what you'd like to see from me in the future. And if you find this feeling like you want more, it's a little incomplete, make sure that you check out my online studio at tessarayyoga.com. I have over 200 videos, full length and short videos, all levels, accessible to everybody. And I think that they are really great and just well-rounded practices. And there's a 7-day free trial right now if you check that out. So let's get started. We're going to start in tabletop position, and we're just going to start with a straight spine. So lifting the skull, lifting the lower abdomen. So sometimes it's really useful to use the hand just to create some proprioception. So with a hand on the lower belly to lift, and the hand on the back of the skull to lift. So we've got this nice long line from skull, scapula to sacrum. And then I'm going to step my right foot out beside me and lean the right knee and hip back. And then the right knee comes down. And then the left foot, lean the knee and the hip back and bring it down. And just do that a few times. Really focus on stability with the lower abdomen and the skull as you just explore your hip mobility, and you will definitely be feeling this in like the sides of your waist, your lower back, your outer hip. Basically, you're going to feel it where you're restricted. Next time your right foot comes out beside you, let's pause there and let's cat-cow. Exhale, curl. Inhale, arch. Exhale, curl. Inhale, arch. Do that a few more times. Okay, and then the left side. So the right knee comes down, the left foot steps out, and we'll cat-cow here. Inhale, arch, and exhale, curl. Still lifting the lower abdomen. And then coming into that straight spine again. So lift the skull, lift the belly, and then see if you can circle this right femur. So the leg bone making circles in the hip. Try not to change the lower back or the pelvis here. And we're not going to do it for too long. Go the other way, just feeling that really nice heat build in that right hip. And we'll take the right knee down, and we'll do the same on the left side. Circle the knee. Lift the belly. Lift the skull, but the chin is tucked. And go the other direction. And bring that left knee down. From here, we're going to step our right foot out beside us and internally rotate this left leg to come up. And then we're just going to lean. We're going to lean and push away. Lean and push away. And you really want to think about the contents of your pelvic bowl. So the space between your pubic and your hip bones, I want you to gather and lift. So we're not heavy into the pelvic bowl, we're rather lifting out of it as we move into the hips. You can always use padding under this left knee. Otherwise, I'm thinking about lifting my femur up into the hip and lifting the contents of my pelvic bowl to just take the pressure off of the left knee. Okay, I'm just gonna switch sides. Hands down, right knee down, left foot out. You can internally rotate that right hip a little bit. Bring yourself up, gather and lift. Lean and push. Very often, I find repetition with a little bit of strength necessary is much more effective than passive stretching when it comes to increasing our mobility in a healthy, balanced way. So that's why a lot of my stuff these days is repetitive movement and not exactly like relaxing, stretchy. Nice deep breaths. Okay, we're gonna move now to sit down into a 90-90 position. So I've got my, I've got my right leg in front of me at a 90 degree angle, and then my left leg beside me at a 90 degree angle. So this is groin on a whole other level. many people find they just need to like lean off to the side. That's totally fine. You know, you gotta start somewhere, right? So it's great. Whatever you're doing is great. Slide your left knee away from you and think about working the left inner groin or left sit bone down. It'll never happen, but the effort is there. If you can be sitting upright, that's the goal. Head, shoulders, ribs, stacking over the pelvis, gathering the contents of the pelvic bowl. And then you can lean on this right hand and pick up the left knee and bring it down. And your body kind of just turns. Open the left knee and bring it down. So here we are again, repetition. We've got the pressure of the left foot pressing into the floor, which is really nice leverage. And this is very unique hip movement. Let the left knee come down and then see if you can be upright and then see if that left foot can lift. It's very possible that you won't be able to move it, and that's okay. That's why you do this regularly. Do it consistently. Show up. If you want to see results, if you want to actually improve, you've got to do it 2 or 3 times a week minimum. And that's just life, right? Just got to be consistent to get your results. And baby steps. Okie dokie, we're going to just go ahead and switch sides. So left leg in front, right leg beside, like beside behind. So left shin, right thigh, lining up with the front or side of your mat. We're going to start with pressing into the right foot. You can lean on the left hand and open and close this right hip, right glute, right groins, right knee opens and closes. Lift the contents of the pelvic bowl. And the knee can come down. Let's see how it goes sitting upright. You can use props or your hands to prop yourself up. Maybe that right foot can lift and lower. Lift and lower. Okay, and then we're gonna try both legs wide. So sometimes it's useful to prop your hips up. If you've got like a pillow or something, you can put that under the flesh of your bum to help yourself sit upright. We're going to experiment with, so ideally you want the toes and the knees pointing up to the best of your ability. And we want to, I like to engage my thighs around my knees, and I'm going to experiment with rocking onto the back and the front of the sit bones a few times. Okay, so again, repetition. There's some muscular effort for some of us in sitting upright. Now I'm going to try, I call it walking on your sit bones. I'm going to push more into one thigh and lift off the other sit bone, and then push down and lift off the other sit bone. So you're going to feel this hamstrings, groins, you're going to feel it where you're restricted. Walking out those sit bones, getting a pretty unique experience in the hips and the groins, big breaths. Something I personally have noticed in releasing this area of the body is how closely linked our nervous system is to tension that we hold in our groin. So just do your best if you're like having a bit of a conniption to soften and relax and breathe. And I'm just going to leave it at that. That's a lot of groin work in one go. So let's hold the knees, bend the knees. You can support the legs and bringing the legs together. And then I encourage you to take a shavasana. Just like I said, the nervous system needs to come down. So come and lay down for just a few moments. You can straighten your legs. The toes can relax. The arms can rest beside you. Close your eyes. And feel the effects of that short and sweet practice. Letting go of any tension that we might hold in bracing ourselves when we do things that are uncomfortable or challenging. So maybe your jaw needs to relax, maybe your hands need to relax, maybe your hips need to relax, maybe your lower back or your belly. So seriously, big breath in. On the exhale, relax. Sink and melt into the floor. And I encourage you to stay here as long as you like. Really feel your body relax and surrender into the floor. And when you're done, come out gently, hit that subscribe button, like the video, let me know how it goes, let me know how it went, let me know if there's anything else you want me to cover, and check out my online studio, and have an amazing day. I hope you are feeling so good. Thank you so much for joining me today, for real, and for allowing me to share my practice with you. Namaste. Mm-hmm.